You know, what's the difference between an elegy and a eulogy? Do you know, Marcus?
No, but I don't know that they were true hillbillies, though. You know.
Oh, I think.
You think so?
Are you kidding me?
You thought these guys were actual hillbillies.
Which ones? Amy Adams?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Think about it. We have been meaning to talk about this for a long time, and we've teased it many times. The name of our show is Country-ish, and so I feel like when the movies pop up about rednecky country hillbilly things, then we need to address that.
Of course. Yeah.
And I watched it. It took me 5 times to watch it because – and it's not the movie's fault necessarily – but I was always trying to watch it at the end of the day, at the night, and I had taken a sleeping pill, and I just couldn't finish it. I tried 5 times to finish this thing. Yeah. And so I finally did. And so if there's anybody that doesn't know what we're talking about, Hillbilly Elegy on Netflix, directed by Ron Howard, screenplay by Vanessa Taylor, based on a memoir of by J.D. Vance. It's got Glenn Close, Amy Adams, just to mention a few. Basically, it follows a Yale law student who must return to his family in Ohio after a family emergency. And there's so many things I could say about this film. I can give you my opinions. You can give me your opinions. Isaiah, did you also see the movie?
Yeah,
okay.
Seen it.
All right, well, hang on to that. I'm just curious. The Alan Jackson, have you seen this film?
No, I have not.
Okay, all right.
I haven't seen it yet.
So who wants to start? Should I start with this? Do we want to show a trailer of it or no? We don't need to, do we? It's been out for a minute. But yeah, we could watch a trailer. Were you allowed to? That's what I'm worried about, if we're even allowed to. Who knows these days, right?
Yeah, it should be okay.
Show it.
Okay, let's just watch this trailer, and then I'll give you my thoughts.
I thought your mama was gonna be all right. Be happy. I know I could have done better. But you gotta decide you want to be somebody or not.
I've been doing real good. I just had a down month.
I got an interview tomorrow, Mom. Otherwise,
Oh, you know me. I always land on my feet.
Don't look at that. Come on. Don't you look at me. You look at me. You look at me.
You let her get away with this every time.
I told you that I would do better.
You always say that. You're lying.
I always try.
You got to think about these kids.
What do you think I've been thinking about since I was 18 years old, huh? Never had a life where I wasn't thinking about the kids.
Do you actually want to be dead, Mom? Or are you just too lazy to try?
Oh, I tried. Plenty.
Always got a reason. It's always someone else's fault. Some point, you're gonna have to take responsibility, or someone else is gonna have to step in.
Who? Huh? Who? You?
Hasta la vista, baby.
How many times you've seen this?
Oh, about 100. Everyone in this world is one of 3 kinds: good Terminator, a bad Terminator, and neutral.
You're a good Terminator.
Well, it wasn't always. I had to learn. You could too.
I love you. I promise that I'm going to do better.
Jenny, you got a right to your own life.
Don't make us your excuse, JD.
Family's the only thing you learn.
There you go. A film by Ron Howard.
Opie.
Which I'm a fan of. Opie, yeah. Now, I'll say this. I think it was good, not great.
Okay.
And I think it's because, now obviously this is based on a real thing and it's a drama, right? But it needed a little bit more of funny things here and there. Not funny, but like lighter moments to make up for all the sadness and drama that was going on. Like even in something like this, where it's obviously trying to be dramatic, you know.
Yeah.
I think it needed a little bit more light moments. So for me, which is probably why I couldn't finish it the first couple of times, is it didn't hold me a whole lot. I thought Glenn Close was great. Amy Adams was okay. She was good. And then everybody else was just, it was just okay to me. What are your thoughts?
I loved it. I thought it was a great movie.
Yeah.
JD, he's in a tough spot.
Yeah.
You know, he's torn in between going back to school, doing his thing, and then the problems he has going on at home. So he's torn, man. But
yeah.
I thought it was a good movie. I would recommend anybody to watch it. I liked it. And like you say, Glenn Close knocked it out of the park.
She was so good.
The glasses. You know, everybody has that mama that everybody has that mama that reminds you.
And at the end, when they show you the actual people.
Yeah.
And how close, no pun intended, Glenn Close looked to the actual grandma that she was portraying in this film. It's so
spot
good.
Spot on, yeah.
So she did a great impression of this real lady. And I had to look up what the word elegy was. Like, I didn't know what, like, hillbilly elegy. So the title alone got me. I'm like, wait, is it like a eulogy? You know, what's the difference between an elegy and a eulogy? Do you know, Marcus?
No, but I don't know that they were true hillbillies, though. You know.
Oh, I think.
You think so?
Are you kidding me?
You thought these guys were actual hillbillies.
Which ones? Amy Adams?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Think about it. She lived up there in the Ohio, West Virginia border.
Yeah.
That's hillbilly town, okay? They were poor, okay? How many times, she was addicted to drugs. She ended up selling her, you know, she ended up being a prostitute a little bit towards the end. She was addicted to crack or heroin, one of those drugs.
Yeah.
She, how many different stepdads did he end up having?
She went through
them. Well, what's more hillbilly than that, really? Well, that's more white trashy, right?
Yeah.
Is that what you're thinking?
That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
More white trash than hillbilly.
Yeah.
I get a different perspective of a hillbilly than I do these guys, but.
Yeah.
What was the elegy?
Oh, yeah. So, intern Isaiah, do you know the difference between a eulogy and an elegy?
I think a elegy is like a short poem.
Okay.
Poem? Did he say poem?
Yes, he did. Poem. I'm surprised he didn't pronounce it poem.
Poem.
How do you say that? P-O-E-M.
Poem.
Poem, yeah. Mm-hmm. Elliot's shaking his head. I mean, Isaiah's shaking his head. So yeah, an elegy.
Sounds weird. How did you say it, Mark?
Poem.
Yeah, that sounds weird.
Yeah. How do you say it again?
Poem.
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 His sounds more poetic.
I like how he thinks. Mine's weird. I think yours is weird.
I think both are acceptable, guys. Let's not fight. It's the end of the year. We're reflecting on positive things. But to answer your question, elegy is a poem of serious reflection, typically of lament for the dead. So there's a eulogy, which is like a celebration of someone's life after death. And an elegy is more of a poem that's not really a celebration. It's kind of like it's like a dramatic. So that's definitely what this movie was. But I don't know. If you're curious about it, I like Ron Howard. I'm trying to think of – I think the main actor, the kid – was just okay as well. It didn't do a whole lot for me. So what about you, Isaiah? Did you like it?
It was good, but I mean, it wasn't like something that I would write home about.
Yeah. There are way better things you could be watching on Netflix. And I'm sad to say that because I wanted this film to be really good based on the title and Ron Howard and the story. So
I thought it was really good.
It ends on a kind of a happy note. Even though there's a lot of crap that goes on.
Yeah, everybody turned out.
Yeah, but
everybody's fine.
Yeah.